came from like the first chunk of writing we did when we went to LA. We got a house for a month and just had writers and friends come over and we just write songs. And this particular one we wrote with Megan and Cole. I think a big part of the inspiration, I remember like initially starting the track, it started with a little OP thing and then we had some acoustic guitars. I think we're trying to capture like, again, like Golden Hour or something like that. We originally, the demo had this very kind of like freeing, driving feel. This morning I tried inside.
On the first day, there was no pre-chorus, and there was no chorus. So I got here. I had written with Megan before, like a year before this, and we had this melody that we wrote that fit really well in this song, and we never did anything with that song. So we ended up taking that melody, changing all of the lyrics, and it ended up in this song, which was really cool.
So I was like, there is something here if we can just manage to like chip through. And it was such a wild day, like trying to write so many different choruses. I don't think I've, for as long as I've been writing songs, I don't think I've ever had like this situation where like a song is a single that's coming out that was like two different songs put together that feels like they belong together.
We decided this time around to start producing our new music ourselves. I think it's really cool that we've been able to kind of take something we've made with somebody else in collaboration, whether that's in like the early writing stages or, you know, first day demos, and then bring it back to the band. Just the four of us kind of tear it apart, put it back together. In the verse, there's only one lead vocal of Rob, and there's no doubles like we would usually do. And that's because when it gets to the chorus, we really wanted it to go from kind of middle and filtered and chill to super wide and aggressive and pop. So there's just this one lead vocal with a chorus on it.
I'll go glued to the mattress.
So smooth.
Looks like I'm stuck in my habits.
It adds a lot of energy. This is what it sounds like without all the delays.
I woke up glued to the mattress.
So then when it gets to the chorus, really wide doubles come in, and they sound like this.
I want something that I'll never find.
There's one set of guitars that I really like forever and ever since I was a kid. I've always wanted to like capture like There She Goes by The Laws in like a song.
It took so long to figure out the bass and the verse.
So how many takes did we end up doing?
So we did 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, plus some inactive tracks. This one is an acoustic guitar pitch down. It sounds so bad. This upright bass. Then we tried this bass guitar, which was just a regular bass. Which sounds nice, but in the song, it just wasn't it. So what we ended up doing was we played the bass again, but we played it on this bass,
the Mustang,
which ended up sounding like this. That is layered the Scarby bass, but mostly just the low end of it because it had like a really clean kind of sub in it. And then we layered just a slap. Alex just, all three of them together sounds like this.
I think the lyrics are so self-explanatory. Like there's nothing coded about the song. Like, it just straight up is just a feeling that you want for yourself and you'll never find it because it's not in you or whatever.
It's like a lot of lines I think we relate to heavily that I know others probably will. And I really love that I want to live in a 90s movie where things just happen so easily. Given that we're like 90s kids, I feel like there's like a 90s movie for us is like the ultimate form of like escapism. Like there's no better form of nostalgia than a 90s movie. And for us, like, that just like tells such a strict story. Like, it takes me right back to like being like a 5-year-old kid in front of the TV with like no worries. And that contrast, I think, in the bridge is like really special.
At the end of the day, the meaning is looking for something that you'll never find, and then just waking up and being like, not today, I'll do it tomorrow.
And it just feels like our first like statement back that feels really strong, and it feels like our most honest representation of like our truth right now.